That's all right. It's in the past now. And that guitar will make someone else very happy, hopefully.
So it got stolen because you left a window, or your bassist left a window open.
Yeah, he left the front window open. We drove kind of late into the night, and we were all just ready to go to bed, and no one double checked.
I've done that before. I remember I went to Bakersfield to visit my family, and they do not live in the nice part. They like Alex, who's in the station. He knows Bakersfield kind of because he's from Fresno, which is the Valley area. And they live by the Union Cemetery on Texas Street. And
Oh.
as you can see, not a good place to be. Yeah, I went with my friend, and I forgot to lock the car door. And literally, we left the car, and I went, oh, wait a second. I have to go back. We turned our backs for just one second and went back, and her cell phone was already stolen.
Oh, man.
It was that quick.
That's rough.
Yeah, that was pretty insane.
Yeah,
So,
it sucks to get stuff stolen, but life goes on, I guess.
You're playing at SLO Brew tonight with
Yeah.
Maps and Atlases. So you're on tour.
We're on tour with Maps and Atlases, yeah. I
Okay.
think this is we're at 3 weeks or something. It's like 33 days. So I think this is one of the longest U.S. tours we've ever done.
Are you where are you originally from?
I'm from St. Paul, Minnesota.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh man,
Twin
that's like
Cities.
way out there.
Yeah. I mean, the Twin
Well, far
City.
away from.
Oh, yeah, very far from here. Well, it's the Midwest, yeah.
Yeah, I've only been out of the state of California once, and it was to go to New York City, so
Oh, really?
I have no familiarity with Minnesota.
Okay. Yeah,
What
the
is
Twin
it?
Cities are awesome.
What is it
Minneapolis is
like?
one of the coolest cities in the country, I think. It's the most bike-friendly country. It's very liberal, or I mean, bike-friendly city. It's very liberal. A lot of great geographical features. The two cities are split by a river and takes 9 minutes to get between them. And you don't exit the city really, you know what I mean? So it's just this I don't know. St. Paul's more residential and Minneapolis has really good museums and stores and really good food.
You know what's funny? San Luis Obispo is actually like one of the more friendly cities in California. I think Matt, weren't we voted the most friendly?
Oh yeah, I
The one
read
by
that.
Oprah.
Yeah, no, Oprah said some other stuff that I don't care about.
Yeah, I did a quick Google search, and one of the taglines under one of the results was the happiest people in the.
Oh, that.
Is that a
Yeah,
joke?
no,
That
well,
was Oprah.
yeah, that was the Oprah thing. There's another thing that said we're one of the most bike-friendly cities in California or
Okay.
America or something like that. So we're
Cool.
bike-friendly too. But there's
Nice.
another thing, Oprah likes coming here. I was born and raised here. I've lived here my entire life. I've never seen her, but apparently she likes coming here.
I lived in Chicago. I mean, I've never seen Oprah in Chicago either. And her
Okay.
studios were there. I bet she just keeps it on the DL a little bit. But
Yeah,
I suppose it's smaller here. There's a better chance of running into her.
that's what is weird about it. And there's a bed and breakfast that I walk by a lot when I walk to downtown. And apparently she stays there when she's in town.
Oh, weird.
And while she was in town, she fell in love with the Big Sky Cafe, which is a really, really awesome restaurant here in
That's
town.
a good restaurant.
And yeah, it's awesome. And my friend that I've known since I was 12, we went to school together, is like his family's friends with the owner's family, because we're a really small town, we all know each other. And she found out the business was failing, and so she fell in love with it and saved it,
Oh,
and
wow.
she became really active and slow. And so I'm always hearing her name pop up in weird places, and that was one of them that she did. So she did a survey, and she was like, San Luis Obispo is the happiest city in America. And I was just like, I mean, we're not the most unhappy, but that's,
Right.
I don't know. I thought it was weird because I'm very unhappy about a lot of things concerning the city of San Luis Obispo.
Yeah.
But I like SLO a lot.
Yeah, it
But
seems cool.
yeah, it's nice. Have you been anywhere in SLO? Have
No,
you?
we just drove in. I got dropped off immediately after entering the city.
Where did you come from?
We came from Visalia.
we our really good friend Willie, he used to DJ here. He's from Visalia.
Oh, cool.
Did you enjoy it there?
Yeah, Visalia was all right. We went to Yosemite the 2 days before.
Oh, man, that's awesome.
Yeah, it was really, really awesome.
What did you do out there? Did you go camping?
No, we stayed in Mariposa the one night, but we did a bunch of hiking in the valley and then did some lookout points the next day and some more like waterfall hiking.
Cool. Did you see Half Dome and Morro Rock?
Oh, yeah.
Man, I love Yosemite. I always went out there with my grandpa when I was younger. Mm. And so he would like go and say, that tree's named this and this is why. And he like knows everything about
it. Yeah.
It's pretty awesome.
Yeah, it was a great experience. I love doing the parks when we're out on the West Coast.
Did you go to Sequoia at all?
No.
It's like right by
there. Yeah, I know that. Cool. We kind of made a decision between Yosemite and Sequoia.
Yosemite's
and chose
good.
Yosemite.
No, it's good. Like, they're equally good. I'm more inclined to Yosemite, too.
Yeah.
So you made a good decision.
Yeah. It's just like a place of legend. We had to check it out.
So how long in the tour are you?
We have, I think we have like 10 days. Or wait, what's the date today? The
30th.
Oh, it's the 30th?
Yeah.
Ooh, wow. Yeah, I think it's like 13 days. We get back to Chicago on like, the 12th or something like that.
So you live in Chicago right now?
No, I actually just moved out of Chicago back to St. Paul.
Oh, okay.
Because I'm planning on going to New York. But I got to save some money before I go out there because it's so expensive.
Yeah. I mean,
and my lease was up in Chicago. And I've been there for like 6 years, so it's kind of just time to make a change.
How is Chicago?
It's great. I love living there. I'll really, like, really, really miss it. I lived in Logan Square, which is this, like, up-and-coming neighborhood. It's kind of, like, exploding right now. It's just, like, an awesome, awesome place. Cool people everywhere. Really nice. Chicago's, it's kind of hard to explain why I like Chicago. You know? It's easier, like, when you ask me why I like Twin Cities, it's easy to, like, point to a lot of things. But Chicago is just, like, kind of like a general sense of living there.
It's like a melting pot, like any other
big
city. It's kind of hard to pick a couple of things. Because I remember, I had never been out of the state of California, and then I went to New York City for a week by myself, and then people asked me how it was, and it was hard to say because there was just, like, so much stuff. And it was, like, a culture shock because it's entirely different from California.
Yeah.
And every moment in my life I have only known in California up until that point.
Right.
And so it was really hard to describe how different it was and how much I liked it.
Mm-hmm.
So you're planning on moving to New York City.
Yeah.
Where in New York City?
Hopefully Greenpoint. That's where we recorded the new record.
I like Greenpoint a lot.
Mm-hmm.
It's
really nice.
Brooklyn.
It's a lot like, it feels a lot like Logan Square in Chicago. And kind of certain things about it feel like Rogers Park, which is where I went to school in Chicago at Loyola. It's like just still very much dominated by the Polish community.
That's why I liked it.
Yeah.
Yeah, I have a friend that lives in Crown Heights, which is kind of by Greenpoint.
It's like north of Greenpoint, I think.
Yeah. And I liked it out there because there was a lot of older Polish families, and they're just like wandering around and minding their own business, and you just kind of get like the feeling of their culture and how like beautiful it is.
Yeah.
And there's a lot of Hasidic Jews that are around, and I feel the same way towards that. It's just like you get to like experience someone else's life, and I like it a lot better than Williamsburg. I took the L train from Manhattan to Williamsburg, and I was like, and I just kept going up and up, and the farther north I went, the more I liked it.
Yeah. Yeah, Williamsburg, I mean,
it's a little too trendy for me.
Yeah, it's just, like, kind of overgrown at this point.
Yeah.
But, yeah, I'm looking forward to moving out there, I think. I've wanted to go out there since I was, like, a junior in college, and I haven't been able to because of the band and everything. And now that it's getting closer, I'm like, do I really want to go out there? Especially when we travel and we go to like such cool cities on the West Coast, I think about moving out here. But I don't know. I think it's something I got to do. Just try it for like a year.
So is that why I heard that this is the last album as a young man?
Mm-hmm.
And is that why? Because you're moving away? You're planning on moving?
No, that's not why. I am moving because it is the last. It's like the other way around, if that makes sense.
Oh.
Yeah, I mean, it was always like conceived as like a finite project. I wanted to like write about what I was going through, and I don't really feel. Yeah, I don't know. This new record, the Beyond Was All Around Me record, is kind of like the punctuation at the end of the project. Kind of the conclusion. I don't really feel like I have anything else to say about like, the transition between or from youth into adulthood. I think I kind of like, covered it.
So basically, this means like I am finally like an adult.
No, not necessarily like that. I think I'll always like retain certain like semblance of my youth, but like I do feel like now I'm you get to a point post college, especially when you just like you stop having these like milestones of like of growth as like a child, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like you go through the schooling system and there's everything is like so like regimented and they're like you graduate from like different grades to different grades and once you get here it's like find a job and do what you want to do now. And there I don't know.
Yeah, I was talking to Matt over here about that earlier. I was telling him like that after college, like it's like okay, so you get a job now and then what? You just keep on doing that. Like it's just a constant. There's no more like oh, and then this happens and then this. I mean that there's still that, but I mean it's varies from person to person. Because like with everybody, you can guarantee like you're gonna go through puberty and you're gonna go into something when you're an adult. Like you're going to go to school or you're gonna go to work. But like after that, it becomes more of like independently like what you're going to do and not like a like an overall like rite of passage. I think the only thing it like left is like okay, like maybe you get married, maybe you have kids. You can rent a car when you turn 25, and then you retire. And I think like that's the next milestone.
Yeah, but I think that is true. It also like simplifies it, and that's why I don't want to write about it anymore. Because like, I mean, just because I'm not in school anymore and not like reaching those different milestones doesn't mean like my life is boring. It's just like now I have like so many different things that I could write about, and that's what I'm more interested in now, is writing about like different experiences that aren't like so focused on, how I got here or whatever.
Well, I mean, some people will interpret it as being depressing. Like, now what? Like, show me like what I'm supposed to do next. But for other people, it's now I'm free. I don't have to reach that point that other people do. I don't have to be in this race. Like, now it's about what I want to do, my personal achievements, and not about the world's achievements together. Well, that's cool. Maybe you can start like an old man.
Yeah, that was that's always the joke too, and that was never the intention of the project, to like have the character like grow past, what I'm discussing now. And it's like a lot of it is autobiographical, but I don't want it to like come off as like the next thing I do is like somehow like a continuation of the character that was like, at the center of those albums. So
Well, I mean, throughout time, sequels have always not been as good as their like predecessors. And so, I mean, it's a wise choice not to do that because I think that like usually like spin-offs or sequels are like mostly hype because people have like they feel really close to whatever's being produced that they wanted to keep going on because they want to keep having this bond with whatever it is, the like the character or the project, like whether it be a movie or a TV show or a concept album or like a band or whatever. They form a relationship with it and they want it to like keep going. They want like the good times to keep going without realizing that they might like slowly destroy it and destroy like the perfectness and like how intact it was by trying to hold on to it. And so like I completely agree with that because spin-offs and sequels like there are a few, there's exceptions, but mostly like they don't really like go over too well.
Yeah. And I feel pretty content about the project now. I'm ready to, just like move past it.
Awesome. Well, we'll talk more, but
okay.
You picked out a ton of records. I want to like play them all. So I'm going to play the Pink Floyd one. And this one is from the record A Nice Pair, which is funny that you picked that out because we always pick it out.
Yeah.
And you picked out
Pow R Toke H.
Yeah.
I still don't know the meaning of that, but I just really dig this song.
Probably has no meaning. It's just like Sibera had schizophrenia and he was like, this is a word now.
Yeah, maybe.
So this is Pink Floyd with Pow R Toke H. And
from Astronomy Divine.
Yeah, awesome.
Lying on an eiderdown, yippee, you can't see me, but I can you. Blazing in the boggy dew, sitting on a unicorn, no fear, you can't hear me, but I can you. Watching buttercups come to light, sleeping on a dandelion, too much, I won't touch you, but then I might. Streaming through the starlit sky,
So we heard a bunch of stuff, a bunch of vinyl picked out by Colin.
Yeah, you want me to talk about it?
Yeah.
Okay, so first it was actually Flaming Mother off of Piper at the Gates of Dawn. I misspoke.
Oh, wait. Play or say what you just heard and then like.
Oh, okay. Yeah. So that was Warm Ways by Fleetwood Mac off their self-titled record. I think I got that on vinyl like 6 months ago, and I had never had a Fleetwood Mac phase, and I just like destroyed that record. And Warm Ways is just like such a tender track. They do tender songs so well. I think that's something that's a little bit missing from like indie music. It's like this weird like balance of like, I don't know. It's something that's like specific to that time period, I think. He's like really tender, like
sweet
country tinged, yeah, like sweet songs. Like twangy. Steely Dan do the same type of thing. And
I
it just,
love Steely Dan.
Yeah, I didn't see any records out there.
We have some because I used to play some on my show with my friend Dan all the time.
Yeah, I really like that band. And then it was Androgynous by The Replacements off of Let It Be, and I was like raised on The Replacements because I'm from, you know, Twin Cities, Minneapolis. And my dad is like a huge music guy and has seen The Replacements like, you know, 100 times or something.
That's awesome. Have you heard their new EP?
No, I didn't listen to it yet.
We have it in here.
It's good?
Yeah, I like it.
Cool. And then it was Thank God for This. I think it's Thank God for the Sinners, actually. By Ty Segall off his new record, or one of his new records,
yeah,
called Twins. And yeah, I just have recently been getting more into him. I just like really respect prolific people, and he's extremely prolific.
Yeah,
he's always putting music out, and he just does like referential music really well, which I respect.
I'm gonna tell him that he's what? That's news to me.
Yeah,
I wanna tell him that because I always hear like people say like really like nice things about him and like how awesome he is, and I'm like, I have to tell him that because he'll just be like, dude, I just smoke weed. I don't do anything else.
Yeah. And then it was Pow R, Toke H, and also Flaming Mother off of Piper at the Gates of Dawn by Pink Floyd. And though, yeah, I mean, Pink Floyd has just messed me up at like multiple points in my life. And I think that was, I got really into Dark Side of the Moon when I was younger, and then Piper at the Gates of Dawn kind of came along. And also, like, the, like, Live at Pompeii. I don't know if you've ever seen that.
I love that. We were watching that.
Like, last week.
Oh, yeah. Really? Yeah, we were watching it in the hotel room the other day. I have it on DVD in my suitcase. It's, like, the go-to if there's a DVD player.
Yeah, I love that one. I remember when I took Latin class in high school, like, we were learning about Pompeii.
Mm-hmm.
And I just used it as an excuse to bring in the movie and say like, oh yeah, this takes place in Pompeii, so my teacher like let us watch it in our class.
Cool.
And I was so stoked.
It's an amazing piece of history.
I just want to know how they got that, like who was like, yeah, sure, play in this big empty coliseum, we don't care.
Yeah, 70s. I do not know. I like, really don't know.
Like, you can never do that now. Like, we're like, hey, like this you know, ancient historical mark, can we just like come in here and like play? Like, people would be just like, no, you hippies, you rock and rollers. That's awesome. So what are we gonna play up next?
Okay, I got two cuts left. The first is Mother by John Lennon.
Awesome.
Which is an incredibly emotional track. Just, I mean, yeah. There isn't much to say that hasn't already been said about John Lennon. So
it's, and also the song's pretty self-explanatory about how emotional it is.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, it kind of wears its heart on its sleeve. And then Sugar Mountain by Neil Young off the Decade compilation, which I have myself. There's so many tracks on this compilation. There was a different one that I wanted to play, but I can't remember what it is, so I'm just going to go with the go-to Sugar Mountain.
That's
close
a good
it
one.
Off in a beautiful way.
I'm sad Alex isn't here. He
yeah,
just
he
left.
He loves Neil Young.
He plays Neil Young on every single show.
Nice.
So
I'm trying to get like, you know, deeper into his discography and everything, because I have a couple friends who are the same way.
Yeah.
I'm just kind of like browsing at this point.
I love him. Like, he's so awesome. And like, what I really like about him is he's like really folky and stuff like that. But then he has his weirder albums. Like he did that like rockabilly album,
mm-hmm.
and then he did Trans, which is his like.
That's new wave one.
Yeah, his new wave one.
His new wave record. I didn't know that.
Oh my god! You know, people hate it and they like talk badly about it, but I like it because he was inspired by Devo, which is like one of my favorite bands.
Yeah.
And when you hear him talk about it, it's like really crazy. It's awesome. And like, he also has a son who he has autism, and his son wouldn't like respond to like what he was saying unless he talked through a vocoder. So that album was kind of for his son and kind
oh, wow.
of because he was inspired by Devo. And so, I mean, people had like talked down on that record. I'm like, no, that's a good record. And it's very like, it's emotional, but you don't know it until
yeah.
you like read about like his son.
Yeah, I should check it out. Trans?
So, yeah, Trans.
Cool.
You should check out the song Sample and Hold.
Okay.
That's my favorite song off
Sample
that album.
Sample and Hold. Yeah, I'll check it out.
But before you check out anything, let's play Mother by John Lennon.
Okay, cool.
You're listening to KCPR San Luis Obispo 91.3 FM.
Thank you.
So you gotta take.
Yeah, gotta go get some food in my body.
And then maybe go to the beach.
Maybe go to Avila Beach, yeah.
Avila's nice too.
Avila, okay.
You can't go wrong. Morro Bay, Pismo Beach, Avila Beach, they're all really
They're
nice.
All good. Okay, cool, yeah.
Pismo Beach is a little bit more like, there's like a lot of stuff everywhere, like a lot of gift shops everywhere. Avila's really small. There's a lot of like tiny markets.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
That sounds pretty good to me.
Yeah, if you want to eat, there's like a little market and they have really good chili fries and it's right on like the boardwalk next to the beach.
Okay, well, I'll do that right now then.
And what's awesome is like there's this place that you can walk. There's two sides of Avila. There's a beach sign like where everybody goes, and then you go, if you walk over this bridge, there's Port San Luis, which is still Avila Beach, and you'll see all these really crazy cool boats. Me and my grandpa used to go there a lot when I was little, like late at night, and look at the boats.
Cool.
And they're painted up like really nice. And then there's like a pier, and there's like restaurants on the pier. And then like there's this little like jetty, and if you walk over it, you can like, there's like a lighthouse that's like out there, and there's like these little like secret beaches that like no one goes to. And I'll walk out there and like sit out there, and it'll just like, I'll be totally alone, and it's beautiful. It's really nice.
Nice.
But the sand's very grainy, really rocky, so.
That's cool. We'll keep shoes on.
Awesome. So what, you want to say like what we heard?
Oh, yeah. You heard Sugar Mountain by Neil Young off of the Decade compilation. I don't know what album it's off of originally. And then Mother by John Lennon from Plastic Ono Band.
Awesome.
One of my favorite John Lennon songs.
Cool.
And yeah, thanks so much for having me.
Oh, yeah. Anytime, like, you come by a town, you can just text Matt or I.
Cool.
And, you know, you can stay at Crossroads. It doesn't matter, like, if you need a place to stay in town.
Okay. Or do shows.
Oh, yeah.
Shows.
Yeah, if you nice. Have any future projects, you can play at the house.
Awesome. We'll be touring on this record for a while, so.
Okay, cool.
We'll be back here, probably.
Awesome. Yeah, yeah, and then I can show you all, like, the, like, weird oddities of Slow.
Awesome.
You'll have like more time. Cool. And then I'll play the other records that you picked out, and so you can listen to them while you're driving.
Sweet.
It'll be your like theme song to the beach.
Cool. And go to the show tonight.
Yes, it's tonight at Slow Brew, and it's Maps and Atlases and Young Man. And
there might be a local opener. I don't know.
Probably. Well, the doors open at 8.
Sure.
Yeah, yeah. Whatever.
I think we go in at 9:30 or 9 o'clock.
Okay, cool.
Cool.
Up next, we have The Residence with Constantinople.
Off of Duck Stab.
Yeah. Oh, that's like my favorite album.
Mm-hmm.
Awesome.
Here I come. Yeah.
Hi.
Hello.
Bethany, how many times have I told you not to huff paint? You're like coming in here and you're like, do you want my clothes? I ate too much candy.
I'm on the ultimate candy high.
Oh my God. I'm having an anxiety attack being
around. I've been eating so many Skittles at the station inside of the MCR.
Yeah, and donuts.
And Starburst, fave reds, only the red flavors.
What about the pink?
Yeah, there's some pinks in there too.
They're good.
Pink's a shade of red, I guess.
Yeah.
It's like light red. Why don't they call pink light red? I don't know.
Because they wanted it to be dumb, like the girls that wear it.
Don't you wear pink?
Yeah. I only wear pastel pink, okay? Because it's like Easter Sunday.
It's like baby pink. So wait, baby pink means baby stupid, right?
Because
you said pink is stupid.
So baby stupid.
I played the records that Colin picked out. Hopefully he's listening. What are you doing? You're ruining this incredible show. Stop drawing on yourself. Get it together. I played Moss, and that is off their album I, and it's released by Burger Records. It's awesome.
Burger Records is awesome.
God, I feel like I have a bunch of children in the station. Like, Matt's touching things he's not supposed to. You're drawing on your face. Just like, ah. So, I played from that Moss record. I played Hedge Creeper. And before that, I played a really long instrumental called Molly Molasses. And those are
back. Which I made a guest appearance on.
Yeah, I know. I bet everybody heard that. But those are back-to-back on the album. Before that was Moon Age Daydream by David Bowie. Starting off our set was The Residents with Constantinople, all picked by Colin. And I'm going to play some of his stuff now to promote his show at SLO Brew, which is tonight at 8. And so I'm going to play off his new album that we just added to the station. It's new. It's in rotation right now. The album is called Beyond Was All Around Me. And it's off French Kiss, which is an awesome record label. And I'm going to play the song Josie. This is Young Man.
And everyone must have a little bit of time. Time to do, 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 do. Time to do, 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 do. Time to do, 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 do. Time to do, 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 do,
That was Wax Idols, and that was the song When It Happens. Before that was Hat Trick by Empress Of. Those are new to the station. Before that was Young Man. That was off of his album that came out last year. That was Due, starting off our set. This is the new album by Young Man that we have in rotation. It's called Beyond Was All Around Me. And I played the song Josie. So check those out. Young Man had an album last year. He has one this year. It's brand new. We have both of them. Everything is awesome. You're listening to KCPR San Luis Obispo, 91.3 FM. Catch Young Man and Maps and Atlas is playing tonight at SLO Brew. Doors open at 8 p.m. Up next, here's DJ May.